Welcome to the Blazor DataGrid tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to connect Microsoft SQL Server data to the Syncfusion Blazor DataGrid component. There are several ways to bind data to the DataGrid, such as using the data source property or the custom adapter. However, in this video, I will specifically focus on remote data binding with a custom adapter. If you want to know about the URL adapter, check the video link provided in the description below. Now let me open the existing Blazor web application. I have already added the Syncfusion Blazor DataGrid component with grid columns for displaying the order details. If you want to know how to add the Syncfusion Blazor DataGrid component to a Blazor web app, check the video linked in the YouTube card above or in the description below. Now I need to retrieve data from the Microsoft SQL Server database. To do that, I'll first show you how to connect the database and bind data to the DataGrid using an API service. To begin with, I've already created a relational database using SQL Server to store the data. To verify the table's creation, expand the created database and right-click on the Orders table and select View Data. This option allows you to see the current state of the table, displaying the database table containing the order details. Here I need to access the data from the order details database. I will set up a controller that will pull data from the DB context and pass it to the Blazor application. For that, first, I create a new folder named Data within the server-side project. Inside this folder, I add a class named OrderData. After creating the OrderData class, I need to add the connection string to interact with database. To do this, let me open the database location, right-click on the Order Details database, and select the Properties option. Here, you can see the connection string in the Database Properties window. I will copy the string and close the Database Properties window. Inside the Order Data class, declare a connection string variable and paste the copied connection string into it. This connection string provides the necessary information to connect the application and the database. Next, to connect to the Microsoft SQL Server database, I need to install the SystemDataSQL client NuGet package. So let me open the NuGet package manager. Here I'll search for the SystemDataSQL client NuGet package and install it. Then import the SystemDataSQL client namespace to use the SQL connection class for database operations. Inside the OrderData class, let me create a public asynchronous method named getOrdersAsync. This method will retrieve a list of orders from the database. Inside the method, I'll define the SQL query string to select all columns from the table and sort the results by order ID. Then declare the order list named orders and initialize it null. This variable eventually holding the list of order objects fetched from the database. Next, I open an SQL connection to the database using the connection string stored in the connection string variable. Inside the SQL connection object, create a SQL data adapter object named adapter using the SQL query and the database connection. The adapter will act as a bridge between the database and the data set in memory, facilitating data retrieval. Then I create a new dataset object named data, which will hold the data retrieved from the database. I open a connection to the database, allowing data to be fetched, and use the SQL data adapter to execute the SQL query and fill the dataset with the results set from the database. Next, convert the rows in the first table of the dataset into an enumerable collection and project each row into a new order object, mapping fields like order ID, customer ID, employee ID, ship city, and freight. These objects are then collected into a list and assigned to the orders variable. Finally, let me close the database connection. Then I return the orders list containing the data retrieved. Next, I'll show you how to connect the Blazor data grid to an API service. I navigate to the Home Razor component and define the Syncfusion Data Manager tag and set the adapter property to Custom Adapter. This allows you to define your own logic for handling data operations like querying, filtering, sorting, paging, and CRUD actions. Additionally, I set the adapter instance property, which specifies the actual instance of the custom adapter class that should handle data operations in the Blazor DataGrid component. To handle this, inside the code block, create a custom adapter class that extends the data adapter class from Syncfusion. This extension allows you to implement custom data binding logic. Inside this class, I define a public order data field named order service, which will be used to access the database service to fetch data. Next, override the read async method, which is crucial to handle loading data from the database based on the request parameters from the Blazor data grid. The data manager request parameter provides information regarding paging, grouping, filtering, searching, and sorting, with all these operations handled on the component side. Inside the method, I declare a data source variable and assign it the result of asynchronously fetching a list of orders using the getOrdersAsync method from the order service. Then, calculate the total number of records by casting the data source for an order collection and counting the items. If the data manager request requires the total record count, return a data result object containing the data and the record count. If not, I return the data source. Finally, I bind this class to the adapter instance property. Now let's run the example application. As you can see, the data grid component is rendered with the data retrieved from the database. Next, I'll demonstrate how to perform various actions in the grid, such as paging, filtering, sorting, aggregation, grouping, and CRUD operations using the Data Operations class. You can easily use these built-in methods or create your own logic to perform these actions. First, to enable the search operation using a custom adapter, I need to display the search option in the toolbar. So let me add the toolbar property and assign it to display the toolbar within search option. Inside the read async method, check the search property in the data manager request for the entered search criteria. If this property is not null and contains search terms, use the perform searching method in the data operations class to filter the data source, returning only matching records. I'll also add sorting, filtering, paging, aggregation, and grouping operations inside the read async method. To enable these operations, I set the allow sorting, allow filtering, and allow grouping properties to true. For paging, I enable the allow paging property to true, since I want to display 6 items per page. So, I define the grid page settings tag and set the page size property to 6. To enable aggregation, add the aggregates to display the calculated sum and average values of the freight column, which will be shown in the data grid's footer. Now let's look at the output page. The pager is displayed at the bottom, allowing you to navigate between pages by clicking the page numbers. Notice the search option in the toolbar. When I search for a record using order ID, the corresponding record is displayed. To sort data, click the order ID column header to toggle between ascending and descending. Additionally, you can see the filtering input box. When I filter a record using the employee ID, filtered records are displayed. You can also see the footer aggregates displayed at the bottom of the freight column. To interact with grouping, when the customer's name column header is dragged and dropped in the group drop, the grouping operation is performed. Next, I will show you how to perform CRUD operations. To start with the insert operation, inside the order data class, I created an addOrderAsync method to bind incoming data to the grid. It inserts a new record into the orders table, executes the SQL query, and closes the connection. For the update operation, I create an updateOrderAsync method to bind incoming data to the grid. It builds and executes an SQL query to update a record in the orders table by order ID then closes the connection. For the delete operation, I create the removeOrderAsync method to delete an order by order ID. It opens a connection, runs an SQL delete query, and then closes the connection. Next, I'll integrate the CRUD operations into the Blazor DataGrid component. I navigate to the Home Razor component, update the toolbar property to include Add, Delete, Edit, and Cancel options. Then define the Grid Edit Settings tag, setting the Allow Adding, Allow Editing, and Allow Deleting properties to True. Inside the Custom Adaptor class, I override the InsertAsync method. This method calls addOrderAsync to insert a new order and returns the added record. To update an existing data item, override the updateAsync method. This method calls updateOrderAsync to modify an existing record and returns the updated order. To remove the record items from an existing collection, I override the removeAsync method. This method calls removeOrderAsync to delete a record and returns the removed order. Before running the example, I set the isPrimaryKey property to true for the order ID column, because the update method is designed to update an existing record in the orders table based on the order ID. Let's run the example application. You'll see the data grid rendered with the toolbar. When I click the Add button, enter a record for all columns, and click Update, the record will be successfully updated. Check the database and refresh it to see if the new record is inserted successfully. To edit a record, select a row, click the Edit button, modify the ship's ID column, and click Update. The record will be successfully edited. Check the database and refresh it to see the updated record. To remove a record, select a row and click the Delete button. The record will be successfully deleted. Check the database and refresh it. The record is deleted successfully. Let me summarize. In this video, I showed you how to bind data from Microsoft SQL Server using a custom adapter in the Blazor DataGrid component. I also demonstrated how to perform sorting, filtering, paging, grouping, aggregation, and CRUD operations using the custom adapter. If you want to see the working code for this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can check if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor components. If you found this video helpful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching.